Den russiske organisasjonen Humanistisk Ungdomsbevegelse dømt til å registrere seg som utenlandsk agent. Det kan bety stans I organisasjonens aktivitet. Tatiana Kulbakina arrangerer demonstrasjoner og skriver om menneskerettigheter og samfunn I organisasjonens nyhetsblad.
It's difficult to make a demonstration, like to walk, because the administration often said that there is no resources, there will be a problem for public transport and so on, and they do everything not to allow you to make a demonstration. In Murmansk, it's possible to make the demo in the center of the city only on the 1st of May, just because they have it in budget.
Politiets og rettssystemets maktmisbruk omtalt I bladet. Hun sier en venn av henne ble torturert I 6 timer etter å ha kranglet med politiet.
He was tortured in a way that you cannot prove that it was torture. Like, okay, you are sitting like this for a long time, like for 10 minutes. And then your muscles are kind of tired or like start to shake. You don't feel it anymore. And then this policeman just started to beat you up. He was already in the blood, and they wear the plastic bag on his head and to put him in the police station, not to, to have no blood on the walls from his head.
Da Kulbakina besøkte Kirkenes I 2014, delte hun sitt inntrykk av rettssystemet som avgjør organisasjonens fremtid.
This is the biggest problem that the court is not independent. The court is often on the side of police, on the side of authorities, but not on your side. But still, there is a freedom of speech, there is a freedom of assembly. You really need just to know how to do this or to be brave enough.